So a hydrophobic surface is a surface where if you were to put a water droplet on it, it'll bead up. So if you think about when you've just waxed your car, water will bead up and kind of roll away. But to create a super hydrophobic surface, you want it to bead up even more. But you can't just do that with a coating like Teflon or a wax. You have to actually put a structure on it. In nature, lotus leaves do this really well. So if you ever look at water beaded up on a lotus leaf, it almost looks like a completely round ball. So what we do in the lab is similar to what we observe on the lotus leaf. We have these structures and we have water sitting on top of them. Superhydrophobic surfaces can be created in a multitude of different ways. Here in our lab, we create rib and cavity structures, or we create post structures. The water sits on top of it like a ball, but in addition to that, I have this air cavity in between. What we're seeing is a drop of water falling onto one of these surfaces. As it falls, you can see it starts to spread out, as you expect a drop to, but then it starts coming back together again. And you can see that it comes back up off the surface altogether. Here we can see the water jet coming down and hitting the superhydrophobic surface. And as soon as it hits it, the water starts to move outward. But because the water is much more attracted to itself than the actual superhydrophobic surface, it starts to create droplets. Water basically just rolls right off of it. Recently, there have been different products that advertise that they super repel water and you can spray it on your boots and the mud will just roll right away. So the idea of those is they're generally some sort of spray coating. Here at BYU, we have the capability of creating superhydrophobic surfaces. So we aren't just looking at droplets on surfaces, we're looking at flow through surfaces. Some of the applications for these superhydrophobic surfaces include applications on really small scales, chip manufacture, biomedical applications, and then any type of application where you want a clean surface, or any application where you might want to reduce the friction drag. Superhydrophobic surfaces are something that will be used in multiple applications in the future.